Binance reveals plan to launch crypto exchanges on almost every continent. Next on your 4-Minute Crypto Daily News. Hello and welcome to 4-Minute Crypto. Now today's show is from a post by Wolfie Zhao at Coindesk.com and is brought to you by BitBlock Boom. Take a look at the Bitcoin Maximalist Conference coming to Dallas, Texas in 2019 at bitblockboom.com. And before I start, I want to remind you to like, subscribe, and share. Now, during a recent fireside chat, Binance founder and CEO Zhao Changpeng, I'm sure I pronounced that wrong and I'm sorry, discussed a range of topics and indicated that by this time next year, he wants to launch 5 to 10 fiat to cryptocurrency exchanges with ideally 2 per continent. These plans fall in line with Binance's current efforts to roll out an exchange in Singapore that supports local fiat to cryptocurrency trading services. Zhao said, "Fiat is still where all the money is in, and we've got to open up that gate." Zhao added that in order to do so, Binance plans to continue working with relatively smaller countries, citing recent partnerships with nations like Malta. The main reason, he explained, is that these countries tend to respond in a much more efficient way. You can get access to the top level government officials and they respond to your questions more directly and efficiently. Now, that being said, Zhao brands his moves as more of finding a sweet spot rather than an entire pivot, stating that in the long term, the goal is still to build a decentralized exchange when the technology matures. Now, during the fireside chat, Zhao confirmed that in the first quarter this year, Binance made $200 million in profits. Woo, $200 million. He added that the profits in quarter two declined due to a market drop with $150 million. Commenting on Binance's rapid growth, Zhao said luck played some role in the company's success so far as it was established with the right thing at the right time. Asked if he was concerned about whether market volatility would significantly affect Binance's business, Zhao responded that he sold his house in 2014 to buy Bitcoin. Afterward, its price dropped from 600 to 200. But despite this fall, he did not sell, adding, "After that, I'm just not that worried." Have you had an opportunity to use the Binance exchange yet? I know I have, and I kind of like it. Let me know your thoughts on Twitter, where I'm at Gary Leland. And don't forget to join me every weekday for a new episode of 4-Minute Crypto. This is a CryptoCousins.com production.